high school. It's so good to see all of your faces again. You all shaped who I have become and I'm from this church, and I just really appreciate all of you guys. I really just, it's kind of like, in order to talk about where I'm going, I can kind of talk about where I've been to. I'm headed, like I said, to California. I'm going to start a PhD program in biomedical engineering up there. But it's one of those things that I definitely could not have gotten there without the Lord working in my life and the opportunities that He provided for me. And I think that my life is not to be, I'm not going to be a biomedical engineer. I'm going to be a Christian who practices biomedical engineering. And I want my life to be centered on that. And you guys have such a big, part of that. So I grew up here, but I went away to UT for undergrad. And I think that it's, like, this is really a kind of a message for the young adults and for parents of young adults. Because it's really hard to be, right, graduated from high school. It's a really hard time, so you finally get out from your parents' thumbs a little bit. It's not that it's bad. But you kind of can make your own decisions. And I did make a lot of the right decisions. I went to school and started trying to find things that made me happy, that I didn't get involved in the church, really. I like, went on Sundays to one and just kind of came and did the thing and left, you know. It wasn't like that God was actually a part of my thoughts or in any of my actions. And so about my sophomore year, I finally hit a rock bottom. I just knew that this is a place that I never thought that I would be. I would have laughed if you had said in high school that I would have been where I was in the middle of my sophomore year by Christmas. And I, you know, I really finally just hit this one. I was like, God, this is not who I am. This is not where I'm going to be. I need to find a church, and I need to find the community of God to help me get back centered on what is actually important. And so I ended up finding this church called Cornerstone Church in Knoxville. If anybody's going to UT and they're still in here, Cornerstone is a great church. It's awesome. I met a couple of girls who were great mentors to me. I started going to a college ministry and started going to church at Cornerstone. And the Lord just drew me back and gave me a love for the gospel that has just abounded and grown. And my cup overflows with joy now in the things that He's done. And through those things, I think that God has honored my faithfulness through so many things that is leading to where I'm going now, is that He opened up internship opportunities. He opened up, the fact that I got into Irvine in general was a miracle. there's a really cool guy that is down in Florida that I am dating only because the Lord turned his heart around and he became a Christian after we met at a Grace National Laboratory. So God has just opened up incredible opportunities just because of that I gave my life to Him 130%. And like, God has shown His faithfulness because He loves to give good gifts to His children. And that is something that God has really made plain to me these past couple of years that I've actually been a Christian. And so I think that I really just wanted to encourage any of you. Who's in the young adult group in here? Is there a show of hands? Like, y'all are in the throes of some really hard times in your life. You may not even see it now. it's a really fun time, and it's a really great time for you to cultivate this independence that you've never had before. This is new independence. But I just encourage you to be wise and to stay connected with the body. I wanted to read the first set of Psalms. So I think one thing that when I was 18, 19, I was seeking joy, and I wasn't finding it in the things that I thought I would find it in. And I ended up only finding it when I got back connected with the body, and I found that only serving Christ is where my joy is found. So Psalm 4, verses 6 through 8 says, "There are so many who say, 'Who will show us some good? Lift up the light of your face upon us, O Lord.' You have put more joy in my heart than they when they have their grain and their wine abound. In peace, I will both lie down and sleep, for you alone, Lord, may me dwell in safety. So I think it's like, even when they have grain and they have wine and everything looks so good on that side, like only the Lord makes our joy abound. And so, and then that's also a word for parents too. I know I've got some people that have been praying for me throughout all of my college years. And I think the Lord gives special attention to my mom's prayers because we're so good. But I had some really, you know, both my grandparents and my aunts and uncles, and people have been praying for me. And I think that one thing is, it's not something that, you know, I have an illustration for this. There was a guy in my church that, this older man, and he developed cancer, and it was super rapidly taking his life. And so we were sending emails through our care group, our life group, or whatever, you know, just praying for him or whatever. And one of the women was like, all we can do is pray. You know, that's all we can do. And it's kind of what's one of the, one of my best friends replied back, that no, like, prayer is not something that we go to as a last resort, and we say, man, like, we've done everything else we can do. Now all we can do is pray. It's like, no, that prayer is our biggest, is our sword in our fight. You know, is the main weapon that we have to fight any of our battles that we have. Prayer is so powerful. And so parents, like, be on your knees. Pray for your children. They, like, the Lord promises good to you, and he promises good to your children if they love him. So don't fret about it. Because you trust in the Lord, you don't trust in our understanding, you trust in the Lord that he has your children, even in these young adult stages, when you're starting to lose your grasp on them, like, God has them, and he loves them, and he loves you, and he has good for you and for your children. So pray for them, be in battle for them, but let God do his work in them. So I just wanted to encourage you guys, and I just wanted to say thank you again for being the church that you've been to me, and for showing Christ to me. You guys have a wonderful morning.
Isn't it great to see someone that has grown up and found their own faith, and they know who Christ is to them, and they're experiencing that full, joyous life that God promises us. That's what we want from our children. I know you're very proud of her, but let's just pray. Father, we thank you so much for Rachel, and we thank you for the relationship, not just that she has, but that we can see in her. And we thank you for the faith that you put in her. And we thank you, Lord, that you are faithful to us. And we thank you that being with you is our source of joy. And that relationship is what carries us through life and gives us that true peace and joy that all of us seek for. And Father, I just pray for all of our kids that are going off to school, because they too will be independent. And they will have a chance to find themselves and to own their own faith. And we just pray, Lord, that you will continue to work in their lives and in Rachel's as you have. And help them to see and to find quickly that you are who they need to center their life on. And that you will give them their heart's desires, not the world. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. So thank you, guys. Thank you. And I'm going to let the kids slip out here in a second, but before we greet each other, I'm going to just give a couple of...